You're listening to the audio production of The Discerning Life, An Invitation to Notice God in Everything, by Stephen A. Macchia, published by Zondervan and read by K.C. Bragg. Please note that you may download an accompanying PDF that provides enhanced materials for this audiobook. To download the PDF, please visit harperchristianaudio.com.
To Ruth Lynn Macchia, beloved soulmate and devoted partner in The Discerning Life, together we are learning how to practice a preference for God. And to Brother David Vryhoff, SSJE, and Methodist Bishop Reuben P. Job, 1928-2015, spiritual mentors and friends, guides to spiritual discernment. Introduction. There's no place like home. The Word became flesh and made His dwelling among us. We have seen His glory, the glory of the one and only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. John chapter 1, verse 14. Far too often, spiritual discernment has been pigeonholed into the exclusive realm of decision-making, learning how to make good choices and know God's will methodically and predictably. We want a simple system to follow. Set up the room, put people in place, consider the right options, add a prayer, and then press the button of discernment. For some people, spiritual discernment is reserved for major ministry or organizational decisions, like calling the right pastor or determining where to plant a church. For others, it's a tool used to spiritualize every single decision. God, what fabric softener do you want me to buy at the store this week? But spiritual discernment is so much more. It's the choice of the bold and courageous to know God intimately. It's an invitation to all who desire a lifestyle that continuously seeks God's presence, power, peace, and purposes. It's a lifestyle for those who want to see God working throughout their personal lives, in good times, hard times, major inflection points, and everyday moments, too. Spiritual discernment is much more than a how-to manual for making good selections from a list of options. It certainly includes wise decision-making, but it begins with a relationship with God and the ability to notice God when He shows up, whether He reveals Himself clearly or mysteriously. The discerning life grows from a heart that recognizes God's loving voice, responds to His gentle beckoning, and knows with certainty that our true home is found in God alone. We embrace the discerning life by learning to tune out the many distractions demanding our attention and daily practice a preference for God. Imagine for a moment how different your life would be if, at the end of a long day, you were able to point to at least a handful of ways you clearly noticed God in your life. You could rest in that reality, giving thanks to the Father for His goodness, faithfulness, trustworthiness, and grace. Then you could point out God to others, giving thanks together in response to what you experienced collectively. You wouldn't have to wait for someone else to remind you of God's great delight in making Himself known. Instead, you would be the one who acknowledges God's presence and then faithfully looks for Him more frequently throughout the day. Friend, God wants you to notice Him, and it is within your grasp to discern His presence. Your true home in God is available today. The adventure of walking with Him daily awaits you. Still, the discerning life needs to be cultivated. We don't consistently have eyes to see Him, ears to hear His voice, or a heart that longs for His presence. We are born with a fresh innocence, pliable to the love that's poured out upon us as children, enjoying the fascinations that accompany each new experience. Over time, our childlike wonder dissipates as our hearts harden to the presence of God. We begin to lean more toward our human capabilities and away from a healthy dependence on God. As this wide-eyed childlikeness and resplendent wonder gradually diminishes, we lose sight of our faithful companion, Jesus, the lover of our souls and the shepherd of our hearts. Think back to the first time you noticed the sunshine and the shadows of others as you walked the beach. Can you recall the joy of standing at the edge of the ocean, your toes getting lost under the sand, your fingers grasping a seashell, and your body being held as the current came and went? Over time, such memories get complicated by the tumult of the tides, and our innocence washes away. Our eyes and ears lose the ability to see and hear God in our midst. So it is with our soul and the awakening we long for in Christ. God knows all about this waning heart condition. He's been consistent in his desire to make himself known since the dawn of time. It's always been a challenge to get, foster, and maintain the attention of the people of God. But God doesn't quit. His patience is relentless. He wants his beloved to know that he resides in their midst. With every moment of our lives, God is giving us yet another chance to notice his love through the beauty in the world, the actions of others, the scriptures, and yes, even in the breath you are breathing right now. And he loves it when, with childlike innocence, we notice his abiding presence and receive his loving embrace. He welcomes us home from our wanderings along the edges of the sea of life, and we vanish restfully in his embrace to resume our companionship once more. All of this is available to you today. The glorious incarnation. God waited patiently for generations to deliver the gift of the incarnation. He revealed himself miraculously and mysteriously at the perfect time, God's chosen time. Those who were open to receive the gift of Jesus the Messiah were radically changed from the inside out. From the moment of Jesus' miraculous and mysterious conception by the Holy Spirit, his earthly mission and ministry was to be embodied in an extraordinary witness, a presence unlike any other. For those who had eyes to see, ears to hear, and hearts to respond, it was unmistakable, quite remarkable, and completely transformational. The incarnation of Jesus ushered in a new way of perceiving God's presence, power, and peace. Reuben P. Job, a mentor to many discerning pilgrims of the past century, including yours truly, called it a life marked by practicing a preference for God, fully realized and graciously exemplified in Jesus. That same life was offered to all who encountered Jesus, the lover of their souls. The dawn of a new day of incarnational attentiveness had arrived. Those who met Jesus and received and embraced his divinity were surprisingly and delightfully changed, never to be the same again. That same invitation to pursue intimacy with Jesus is ours today. It is an invitation to the discerning life, noticing everywhere, every day, and in everything, the loving presence, power, peace, and purposes of God. God is with us. He desires to be noticed. He longs to be known. He seeks to be welcomed into the home of our hearts as we are consistently welcomed into his. Throughout the Old Testament, the people of God awaited the miracle of the incarnation, the awe-inspiring arrival of Messiah Jesus, born humbly and faithfully as the prophets foretold. The early pages of the gospel narratives give us a few important snapshots of those who witnessed his entry into earth, the residents we call home. Zechariah, Elizabeth, Joseph, and Mary experienced the discerning life firsthand. Theirs was an intimate encounter with angelic visitations and the empowering presence of the Spirit. For them to miss seeing and hearing from God would have required a deliberate turning away with a stiff arm, a deaf ear, or a hard heart. Thankfully, they were each ripe for a fresh encounter with the living God, and the Lord used them powerfully for a grand and eternal purpose, witnessing the humble arrival of the long-awaited Messiah, Jesus. Their hearts were warmed and prepared for all that was in store for them, God reached out to them with a mighty and merciful hand, seeking to take up full residence within, and they welcomed him into the home of their hearts with receptive joy. Think for a moment about what was asked of and offered to Mary, a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The promise to David so long ago that a Messiah would come from his house and lineage was embodied in Jesus. And he came through the discerning life of Mary, who received in her womb the miraculous Son of God. The angel Gabriel comforted Mary, urged her not to be afraid, and promised the Holy Spirit's presence and power. He convinced Mary of the validity of God's protection. In response, Mary sang, "A virgin became a mother, and her womb became a home for Jesus, Emmanuel, God with us. And now we sing." Just as Joseph and Mary, the shepherds and wise men, said yes to God's work in their hearts, so too are we to welcome Jesus into the center of our hearts. We too can experience Emmanuel, God with us, noticeably but mysteriously changing us day by day, one moment after another. He radically enters our lives and invites us to receive his miraculous love today and forever. Presence, grace, and hospitality. The analogies for discernment are plentiful. One could liken discernment to traders on the floor of the New York Stock Exchange, making rapid moves within a given time frame. Physicians in the ER making swift and life-saving decisions. Or police, firefighters, and other first responders coming swiftly to the aid of those in need. Discernment is required of any who are called upon to make quick and bold decisions in the moment. Others might see discernment in politics, where finding compromise is paramount, in sports, where game plans matter, or in entertainment, when an emotional response is created from what appears on screen. Some may equate discernment with preparing to teach in a classroom, choosing the content and presentation style most appropriate for one's students. Still, others may see discernment as the ability to act promptly, calculate, ruminate, stimulate, regulate, and make decisions precipitously. In such nimble settings, the smarter and swifter you are, the better your results, hopefully. But in the world of spiritual discernment, fast and first and most are not the way we are invited to live and learn as followers of Jesus. At times, the discerning life will require agility and the God-given ability to pivot swiftly and gracefully. However, there is another pace, posture, and process for those in pursuit of spiritual discernment as a lifestyle. It's the pace of God, the one who lives with and among us in the daily rhythms of our hearts and households. It's a way of life that slows us down, fills us up, and opens us to a greater and deeper attentiveness and a richer, more fulfilling existence. As a result, more apt analogies for spiritual discernment are organic and related to everyday life. We could, for example, consider the analogy of creation. Discerning God is indeed like observing the created order of how mountains and rivers, trees and plants, animals and wildlife, seasons and weather patterns all work in harmony with one another. Noticing the intricacies of creation keeps us appropriately focused on discerning God. We observe the created order and its need for water, nutrients, and sunlight. We watch how all of creation grows and matures as God ordains. We see how weather patterns express the power of God and the growth of all living things. Likewise, weather forecasting is akin to discernment, detecting the conditions of the environment and offering a prognosis for the days ahead. For the purposes of this book, the metaphor we'll be using is centered on the homes we occupy and the hospitality and house care we engage in to maintain the quality of our daily lives. To do so, we must notice the condition of our homes, discern and attend to what's needed, and find joy in the results. These are things we can all relate to, regardless of the size of our home. Just as our physical home needs daily care, so too does our discerning heart. In our homes, we practice forms of hospitality for those who visit or reside there, family, friends, or even alone. In soul hospitality, God invites us to abide in Him as He chooses to reside in us. Therefore,
we hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.